hogs.
Oh, did you have a good Hanukkah?
I did actually, but you know what? You should actually say holiday now. It's more inclusive in case you're talking to someone that doesn't celebrate Hanukkah.
Oh, well, I guess that makes sense. So, how was your holiday? What did you do?
Well, me and my girlfriend and some friends went skiing in Utah over the break.
Oh, girlfriend, huh?
Yeah.
Isn't that cute Oriental gal that you were always talking about?
Yes. Yes, it's Ming Wei, but Grandma, please don't say Oriental.
Why not?
Well, because it's offensive. You can say Asian or Asian American, or you can refer to their heritage specifically.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not used to all these new politically correct terms. You'd think after having a darky president for 8 years, I'd be more hip to the times.
Oh.
Voted for a place.
Grandma, did you just say darky? What is wrong with you?
Oh, excuse me. Color.
Oh, Grandma, no.
What, now that's offensive too?
Yes, and it has been actually for a very long time.
Fine.
Oh, Grandma, I know. You can say African-American, or just black, or mixed race.
How is an old lady like me supposed to keep up with all these changes? People just need to make up their minds what they want to be called.
All right, Grandma. You have TV, yes? Okay. And you have the internet. I showed you how to use your tablet. Yeah, okay. It's not that difficult.
How do I know what's accurate and what's fake news? People think the elderly are so gullible, but we aren't.
I understand. Okay, from now on, if you're unsure about something, just ask me.
I do. Nice. Thank you for keeping me informed. I don't want to be one of those old people everyone thinks is racist just because I don't know the hippest terms.
Hey, Sam says hi.
Sam Anderson?
Yeah.
Who used to live next door to you? Oh, you two are still friends.
Yeah.
I always liked him, even if he was a little light loafers. How is he?
They.
They who?
Sam.
You said they.
Yes.
What?
Okay. Sam is gender fluid. They don't identify specifically with male or female, so we use gender neutral terms like them and they.
They is plural, not neutral. I was a grammar school teacher for 40 years. I would know.
I know, but since gender is a spectrum, we use words like them and they that encompass all genders, and in this instance, it actually does make sense.
Spectrum?
Yes.
You mean like that sweet Netflix show with that little retarded one? On the spectrum.
Grandma, he was autistic. Please don't say retarded.
Why not? The definition of that word is less advanced in mental, physical, or social development than is usual for one's age. There's nothing wrong with that word!
I understand, but you know, a lot of people have used it in a really offensive way, and it makes people uncomfortable, so just please stay away from it.
Alright. Everyone is so damn sensitive these days. Back in my day, we had thicker skin. We had to. We never knew when some man was going to get handsy with us or expose himself at work.
Well, things are changing now for the better.
I guess I can adapt.
Yes.
I'm a college-educated woman, after
yes,
all.
Yes, you are.
As long as, you know, I can still call a gang of white men marching, carrying torches, wearing swastikas and yelling, Jews will not replace us, Nazis.
Actually, they prefer to be called white nationalists now.
For crying out loud!
And the military considers it a weapon of mass destruction. So we're going to go with the ban for least resistance.
Ah, you approached the FDA then.
Yeah, some of the test animals actually survived the product trials, so we're going to market this to the health food sector.
Right, yeah. Jerry and I, we've really been synergizing our concept, you know, crunching the metrics and really targeting our demographics.
And what did you come up with?
Well, we wanted to go for something that was kind of a retro, Euro, neo, upscale classicism. Moist, but not funky.
Food! Ingest the alternative!
So that's what this stuff is? Fied?
Food. You know, retro-futurist health food for the new age. It's cutting edge. It's micro-macrobiotic.
It's goddamn gross is what it is.
Well, it's all about the marketing. I mean, cannabis basically seaweed, right? But sales are up 200% this year.
Right, so that's why we decided to come up with something like this.
Food! Taste the burn!
Ooh, I like that. So what are the health benefits?
Well, each food bar contains a full daily supply of cesium, strontium, and hydroxycephalone.
Okay. Now, are those actual vitamins?
We can't legally say that food contains any vitamins per se, but we can highlight other substances with health-like effects.
Such as?
Euphoria, mild osteoporosis.
Food puts the crunch back in your bones!
Intermediate hallucination, gripe influenza, Finnegan's elbow, Bell's palsy, mange, and mild death. Oh, and also extreme addiction.
How extreme?
Test subjects have gained an average of 50 to 70 pounds over 2 months.
Oh, wait, and we're marketing this as a health food?
Well, health-ish.
Don't be selfish, get health-ish!
Right. So for those who are squeamish about the weight gain, we have a sister line of products. Food Light.
It's got all the same great food taste with none of the added sugar.
Well, great. Well, sugar-free version.
No, sugar-free. You see, both Food and Food Light each contain 200 grams of sugar per serving and have been known to dissolve teeth in contact. What I'm talking about is sugar, which is a sweet and sugar-like substance that's an industrial byproduct of processing corn husks and coal tar through a nuclear furnace.
Right, exactly. So what we do is we market Food Light as a health food, regular food as a protein, supplement for weightlifters, and then when you put corn husks on the packaging, that allows us to put natural flavors. It's a win-win!
Food! God help us! We hate you!
Alright, well, I hate to throw around meaningless phrases like responsibility, or conscience, or basic human decency, but how are we going to be able to produce this product without a shitstorm of consequences?
We roll it out through the social media, we get some fringe experts who distrust the mainstream media and doctors.
Right, exactly. People like Dr. Oz, or Alex Jones, or... Gwyneth Paltrow. What? There's that guy who shot his homemade rocket into the stratosphere. Let's see if he's available.
Exactly. And with all these candy bars out there disguised as nutritional supplements, food practically is a health food.
Yeah, you see, it's all about lifestyle branding. Four-dimensional key performance indicators. Whole brain trans upscale metacriticism.
Food! Just keep eating! Damn you!
Oh my god. Make a note to develop a mint flavor.
Yeah. All right, that sounds good. We're going to get going on the ad campaign.
And I'll get the necessary legal clearances.
And we're going to get you some new teeth.
More playing time than him. How is that fair?
It's not about fair. It's about giving my team the best chance of winning each week.
Okay, but my Johnny is special.
He gave up 5 touchdowns so far this season. Curtis! You want to run wind sprints, Curtis? Don't give up on the play!
He also got an interception.
Which he then fumbled, and the other team took back for a touchdown. So, 6 touchdowns.
Because he hasn't gotten enough playing time.
Or because he's afraid of contact. At practice, he got hit in the helmet with the ball, and he curled up onto the ground crying.
Well, he was probably concussed.
Or he's just a huge kitty cat.
Kitty cat?
Yeah, I'm not allowed to call him pussies anymore.
How dare you! My son is not a pussy kitty cat! I bet you wouldn't speak this way to his father if he was still around.
I probably would have called him a kitty cat a lot sooner.
You are deplorable.
I'm a football coach. Oh, come on, you bunch of kitties. Stop rolling around on the ground like you got balls of yarn. Hit something!
I bet you would never speak this way to Jared Lawrence's mother.
Yeah, you're right. She's never been here.
Oh, but you would talk this way to her if she was here?
Nope.
So you admit there's a double standard.
It's because her son has run in 19 touchdowns this season so far.
Always stats, stats, and more stats. Why do you people need to obsess over the stats?
Because stats give us information that make us have a better chance of winning. Ah, you guys hit the showers, but no soap. We don't need your fingers any more slippery. And no fancy feast stamina budanza for you, Sneed.
There is more to being the coach of the Chicago Bears than winning.
Taco bar is always open.
Right. I would just pour her shots until she passes out. Then, if she doesn't protest, I mean, I just take the taco.
Jesus! Guys, what the hell's wrong with you? No, you never take somebody's taco without their express permission. It's just wrong. Talk to her, ask her about her day, flatter her. When she gives you a taco, savor it. And never ask for a second one, because that's just greedy. Unless it's late and you're really, really, really hungry.
Hey, hell! You are all so miserably wrong!
What?
Why anyone would ever give any of you her taco is beyond me!
Yes.
Final question. You are sitting at your office desk at work. An intern, whom you find extremely attractive, comes in with some paperwork you requested. You would like her number very much. She hands you the documents and begins to leave. What do you do?
Wait. How hot is she?
What does that have to do with anything?
Her level of hotness totally affects how we play this. Like,
yeah, totally.
So
yeah.
Like, is she, like a girl next door, like Natalie Portman kind of hot, or is she like a Sofia Vergara, like super hot?
Let's just say she's Shakira hot.
Whoa.
Does that help?
Dude.
Wow. Oh, wow. Okay, well, that's easy. What you do is you tell her she looks overworked, and then you offer her a back rub.
Chicks
love that smell.
Yeah. That would never work with a Shakira hot girl.
I mean, maybe it would work with like a Jennifer Lawrence type.
I like her. She's so quirky and down to earth.
Seriously, bro?
No. With a Shakira hot girl, you've got to be much more.
No, guys, we have to think outside the box on this one.
Okay?
No, that's not gonna
happen. I'm gonna go so right now.
Alright, I think we got this. Take the paperwork, say thank you, and don't take out our penises.
That is correct! Congratulations, you passed!
Nice!
But just barely. I suggest you keep a low profile for the rest of the semester. Hey, hon. Oh, yeah. Just finished my last class. I'll be home in about an hour. You gonna be there? Good. It's Taco Tuesday.
Jamie, I'm so glad you're back. How are things in Louisville?
Ugh, please, say it right.
Louisville.
Louisville.
Louisville. How was it?
It was good, actually. I had lunch at this great little farm to table place. It was delicious.
I can't wait till I can go to Louisville to try it.
Good. Oh, hey, didn't you just get back from New Orleans? I'm sorry.
New Orleans?
Nollins.
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 Oh, it was fantastic. I had a million of those little beignets from Cafe du Monde.
Oh, my God, I love those little French donuts.
Awesome.
How are you?
Okay. Oh, hey. Alex, welcome back.
Hey, thanks, I just got in.
How are things in Minneapolis?
Minneapolis.
Menopause.
Doubles,
small fry, and can I get a cup of water as well?
Sir? Sir, I'm sorry. All we have are rations.
But no, look, it's right there on the menu. McDoubles, fries, small, and I know damn well you give out cups for water. That comes out to about $5.50. I know, it's my usual order. Here, that should be enough.
Actually, we don't have any of that. We only have MREs. It's actually the only reason I'm still here. The water was deemed unsafe to drink. And I guess if you have your script, I can totally give you an MRE. Would you like Salisbury steak?
What the hell is an MRE?
Meal ready to eat?
God, what is with everybody? First, I couldn't get my unicorn frappuccino, and now no McDoubles?
I can't
take it anymore!
No.
I'm leaving, I'm out!
No!
Like a refund.
Your money? It's still on the counter, sir.
Well, then I would like a coupon for a free McDouble on my next visit.
We're not gonna die! Oh, I'm gonna find you, Bill! God! Go! The steak is good! He's real good! Oh, no, Bill! Bill! I wonder if they play games again?
Anyways, coupons?
What is wrong with you?
Whoa. Look, I'm the customer. I'm always right.
You are an asshole. Can't you? We are in the middle of World War III out there. You come in here and you're all buttered about some burgers?
What the hell are you even talking about? World War III?
Yeah, World War III. What did you think was going on out there?
I don't know. I mean, I don't really pay attention to news or anything. It's too depressing, you know?
Seriously? So you had no idea that we're at war with North Korea and Iran and Iraq and Russia and China and Belgium?
No, I thought it was the traffic or the Bulls or something.
Okay. How is it possible for you to think that charred vehicles and craters in the road and tanks are the Bulls?
This is Chicago. I mean, come on. Duff! Hey, what's going on, man? Hey, did you hook up with that hot cheerleader last night? Oh my God, she was smoking hot. No, I'm just getting some lunch, man. I'm trying to. I don't know. She's going on something about a war.
Oh my God, you're an idiot.
Really? Yeah, look, I have no idea what's going on, man. She's crazy. She won't give me my McDoubles. I don't know, 7, 6.5?
I hope the sniper gets you next.
Yeah, look, Duff, I gotta let you go, man. I gotta eat something, you know. Blood sugar and all that. Yeah, I'll talk to you later, you giant nozzle. Rude. I just came in here for a burger.
In the middle of a war zone!
Oh, like maybe your war zone, but I don't have anything to do with this war, okay? I mind my own business.
Really? So, because this isn't your war, they can't hurt you?
Oh, yeah, pretty much. Except now I have to go over to Burger King to get a Whopper. And to be honest, that hurts a little.
Seriously?
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't hate Burger King, but right now I'm not loving it.
Too bad. Because, they blew up the Burger King.
Damn. Wendy's.
Flattens.
Taco Bell.
Go on.
Jesus. What the hell's even left then?
Just the White Castle.
What?
Yeah.
No! Oh, God! No! Liquid burgers! No! Oh, God!
I bet that MRE doesn't sound so bad now, huh?
Die, American scum! That was for the beast line.
So many Belgian waffles, I regret.
Oh, don't shoot, bro. Don't shoot.
But why?
Because it's not my war.
Oh,
I am so sorry for your trouble.
What is your problem?
Keith, what's going on, man?
I'm not really into the whole recycling thing. nerve thing. Nerve!
Listen, Ben, about me and your mom.
Bangs! Yeah, I didn't know that's why you're still here.
Okay! Dude, that's not cool!
What?
Mom!
Just because I'm young doesn't mean I'm stupid.
Yeah, I did not say you were stupid. You're kind of a smartass, but...
Oh, I see. So you bring out intelligent things to say, so now you're resorting to name calling.
I did not call you a name.
Yeah, you did. Just then. You called me an ass.
Look, you twisted my words up, you little twerp.
Oh, I'm sorry. You out of ammunition?
There's one for you.
Jeez. Now you're resorting to violence.
I kid. I'm just trying to get to know you.
What? Like, you got what you wanted. Why don't you just take off like the rest of them?
You don't know what you're talking about.
I know you're going to play ball with me because my mom asked you to.
No.
No, no, it's okay because I'm only playing ball with you because she's paying me $10.
$10?
Yep.
Man, you are one tough little dude.
Well, you have to be. You never know when a chug-a-chug is going to come along.
All right, I see what you're doing here. I know what you're doing. You know, people try to connect with you, they try to get close, and you just wind up shitting in their cornflakes.
Oh, you're not as obtuse as you look, Mr. Bronson.
Hey, I don't know what that word means. But I do know that it pissed off the warden in Shawshank Redemption.
It means dumb!
Son of a...
Oh, I'm sorry, what, you need to reload?
All right, Ben, look, you're not going to make this easy, so I'm just going to come out and tell you. Your mother and I are getting married. Son.
You know my little sister's retarded, right? No, really, full sling blade. I mean, she's functional, but she's gonna live at home for like ever.
Nice try. What's the matter? Out of ammunition?
You know my mom's got 5 other boyfriends, right?
Hey, that's cool. I don't mind.
And, you know, she's always going to the pharmacy to pick up Zavarax, right?
Zavarax?
Yeah, it's the herpes cream.
That's cool. Who do you think gave it to her in the first place?
And you know she used to weigh 300 pounds.
Fantastic. It's more for me to love.
Really not going to leave, are you, Mr. Brunson?
Nope.
You know, if you hurt my mom, I'll sneak into your room while you're sleeping and kill you.
Look, Ben, I'm not going to hurt you, or your mom, or your little sister. So after this little talk, I might lock the bedroom door, you hear what I'm saying?
Now you're going to molest me.
Ben, I am not going to molest you. You're not my type. No, I'm just kidding.
I will kill you.
Now, Gerald, as our guest, you get to
choose today's dish.
That's right. I chose. I'm the great chooser. Okay? It was a great choice. Like the time I chose to write a book, great choice. It had all the words, the bestest words. It was called Grab Life by the Kitty Cat. It was a wonderful book. Okay, sold more copies in the Bible. Okay?
What are we going to be cooking?
We are going to be making chicken salad. I'm going to make you a great chicken salad. I'm going to make chicken salad great again, okay?
All right. Well, good. We already had a chicken salad episode, but I'm sure this one will be just as good.
Wrong. That was a fake episode. Never happened, okay? There's no proof at all whatsoever. The only real chicken salad episode is this one, okay?
Okay. Well, as our guest, you get to cook first.
Wrong. You save the best for last, okay? And I'm gonna make the bestest dish. That means I go last, okay?
Okay. I have a great chicken salad recipe. First, I went to my friend Otis's farm, where I befriended and then slaughtered my very own perfect Rhode Island red chicken. I then sauteed it over a bed of live oysters, caviar, morel mushrooms, and 3 pounds of saffron. But store-bought free roasted chicken will work too.
Wrong. Fake chicken. Totally fake, okay? Look, everyone knows chickens come from the sea, okay? Chickens.
Okay. Now, most people would just have it already, would shred it themselves, but I've pre-shredded this chicken. Now I'm just going to add it to my imported Swedish mayonnaise.
Wrong. Fake mayo. Said fake mayo on the jar. Okay, completely fake.
Now most people would stop there and just put in some celery and salt and pepper, but wait, there's more. I've also cut grapes in half.
Wrong. Fake. Fake grapes. Fake knives. Fake halves even.
And then there's one more little thing. Just between you and me, I'm also going to put in some cayenne pepper for a little heat. My husband, Geoffrey, loves the way that it warms his mouth.
Look, it's all fake. She's keeping secrets about her fake food making, okay? She's a nasty fake food making woman. The only food maker around here is me. I'm the bestest food maker.
All right, why don't you show us how you make chicken salad?
First, I would just like to take this opportunity to thank this audience. You're great. I mean, actually, I'm doing great, which means you're great as well.
Right, but what ingredients will you be using?
All of them.
All of them? All of them?
I'm going to be using all the ingredients, okay? First, we're going to start out with some real chicken, okay? Not the fake one, all right? Then we're going to use some real mayo, not fake meat, from a real Mexican chef and real Mexicans, okay? He's totally here, really, with his, like, real fake, you know, food-making papers. Maybe real papers. Just can't see him, okay? Don't ask him.
That seems impractical.
And then we're going to add some tomatoes, because I know tomatoes have salad. Salads have tomatoes. I'm the salad expert, okay? Then we're going to add some cucumbers, and some dill, and some diet pills, and some chocolate pudding, and we're going to top it all off with a real cayenne pepper for a great kick, okay?
I'm sorry, did you say diet pills?
Look, you need the diet pills. My daughter has diet pills, and she loves them, okay? Look, you don't want a huge daughter. She loves the diet pills, and she is, if I may say so, quite the looker, okay? I've had dreams, wet ones, all right? They're great.
All right. Well, I believe the time has come for us to taste each other's dishes. Well, yours looks unique.
Ye uniquest.
You can really taste the diet pills.
And a hint of cucumber.
And replacing your chicken salad.
You son of a
Fine!
Now the time has come for you, the audience, to determine which one of us made the better dish by your applause.
Look, I'm gonna win, okay? Totally gonna win. If I don't win, it's totally rigged, okay?
All those for my actual chicken salad.
Thanks, Putin, you're great.
out of the house past 9 o'clock in like 6 months.
And why is that exactly?
I have kids.
Ah, fair point. Hey, how are they, by the way?
Well, you would know if you had blocked her on Facebook.
Wait, Gene? You blocked me?
Damn it, Gene! Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sweetie, but like, I couldn't take any more posts of, here are 30 photos of my children doing completely mundane things that no one gives a crap about but me! I love you, but come on!
This is why Gene is their godmother, not you.
Only for that I thank you, both of you, actually.
We haven't been friends since, like, high school.
Anyway, how are the kids doing? Camden's in what, eighth grade now?
Yeah, just turned 13, so it's all hormones and exciting new body hair and sticky socks.
Ew.
I told him to pick his laundry up off the floor in his room, and he said, it's clean. I like it where I can find it. I said, judging by the smell, nothing in this room was clean. Do you know what he said to me? It's fine, Mom. If my underwear gets dirty, I can turn it on inside out and wear it again.
Okay, that's, it's really gross.
Super gross, yeah.
Yeah, young man, I'm raising a joint society.
Yeah. Hey, Mike and I went out to dinner the other night, and we could overhear the table next to us, and oh my god, this poor woman. Pretty sure she was on the worst date ever.
I mean, how can you tell? I mean, sometimes you think things are horrible and other people think they're pretty cool, rewarding, like...
Yeah, okay. So, he asked her what kind of wine she wants, and she says Riesling. Then, he actually proceeded to order the Cabernet. He looks at her and he's like, you're out with me tonight, babe. I want you to experience real wine.
Well, maybe he was trying to expand her horizon.
No. After that, the waiter comes back to ask about their order, and he's all like, we're both gluten intolerant. The server looks down at their half-eaten bread basket. I could hear her internally screaming, but she just, you know, shrugged and took the order and walked away. After that, he just turns to the date, and he's like,
yeah, I always say that to waiters. That way they have to make all of our food fresh, and they can't just give us anything that's laying around in the kitchen. Pro tip.
Yeah, I can't come up with a defense for that.
That is awful.
You should have live tweeted it.
Oh my god, why did I do that?
Why would anyone want to read about a live tweet bad date?
Are you never on the internet?
So Todd came over last night.
Wait, who's Todd?
Oh, just her mysterious new boyfriend that she's been seeing for over a month and I still have not met.
How did I miss this? I miss everything.
You should hang out with us more. We go to brunch every Sunday at Nature's Best Cafe.
I love Nature's Best Cafe.
Oh, well, how about you put some of Camden's Inside Out underpants on and then just get your butt there and join us.
Oh, okay. Oh, God. Ha ha.
Ha ha.
I thought it was funny.
So?
Todd?
Oh, so Todd is standing there in the kitchen.
What does he look like? How old is he? Oh, where is he from? What does he do? How does he spell?
Wow, live vicariously much.
Don't judge me.
So he's 27.
Yeah.
He has brown hair. He has blue eyes. He owns a yoga studio.
Nice.
He's vegan.
Wait. He's vegan? This is new information. How is that working?
Well, I mean, like, it's taking some getting used to.
Of course.
I downloaded a lot of pictures of baby animals to my phone. So I just look at them before I have to order anything at a restaurant.
Does that work?
It mostly makes me just hungry for lamb. So anyway, Todd is standing here in the kitchen, and he's doing the dishes.
Okay.
And I walk up, and he's like, hey babe, you've had a really long day. How about I finish this up, and then I'll draw you a bath?
My husband tried to draw a bath for me once.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I had to clean out the tub first.
Yeah, that's how
it works. Basically just lit a candle and dropped a bath bomb in.
What you got, a bath bomb?
A fried chicken scented bath bomb.
Wait, is that a thing?
Yup. And later on that day, when I went to the post office, some guy yelled at me, lady, you smell finger licking good. I may have actually been asking for that one.
Oh, hell no. KFC scent is not consent.
Yeah.
Ever.
shower after coming from the gym, and I had to meet up with Todd for coffee. And I came in, and I tried to apologize, and he was like,
"No, that's okay, babe. You always smell like sunshine and springtime to me."
Oh, that's me. Oh, damn it. Romeo 6969, reply to your comment.
Is that still going on? I guess it do.
Yeah, look at it.
Oh, this internet troll that keeps commenting on our status about men being better allies.
Okay, here we go.
I'm just saying that it's a natural instinct for guys who want to touch something they find attractive. It's a compliment. People pet dogs without asking permission all the time. No one says boo about it.
Are you kidding me? You shouldn't. Oh, they may not be kidding.
Todd just texted me and I told him that he could stop by around midnight because Kara usually has to be home by 11:30.
So what'd he say?
He said,
"Hey gorgeous, looks like the girls are still there. Do you want me to come in or do you need some more time with your friends? I can go get a workout in or something."
It's midnight? Holy crap!
Yeah, Camden has soccer practice at 7 a.m. tomorrow, and Greg can't take him because, as he says, Sunday mornings are for coffee and quiet contemplation.
Yeah, I guess I should probably go too. I have a presentation due on Monday, and if it's not done by tomorrow afternoon, I have to listen to my business partner's procrastination doesn't get you adequate compensation speech.
Is that a thing?
I have no idea what that even means.
Okay.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
I'll see you on Sunday.
Yes. Oh, hey, babe.
Hey, gorgeous. Did you have a good time with your friends? They could have stayed longer. I don't mind. I could have spent some time with them all.
That's fine. We're just winding up anyway. How was your day?
It was okay, I guess. I was starting the 6 p.m. Bikram class, and everyone was getting centered when this client comes in and she's all like,
"Oh my god, it's so hot in here! Can we turn the air on? My hair is gonna frizz!"
Thanks for the great day, Uncle Sam.
It was my pleasure, Billy. I'm glad you had fun.
I had so much fun. I love shooting the heads off of those dummies.
You sure did. But you know, you also learned things while you were having fun.
Gee, Williker, no way!
Yes, Billy, you did. You learned all about the importance of racial profiling.
What's that?
Well, racial profiling is when you judge somebody based on their heritage or the color of their skin.
Oh, like how we only shot the dirt dummies with the things on their heads?
Exactly.
Racial profiling is fun!
It sure is, Billy. But you know, it's also important for our national defense.
It is?
Yes, Billy, it is. Without racial profiling, we wouldn't be able to stop all those nasty immigrants from marrying our daughters.
But what does it have to do with the national defense? Please explain, Uncle Sam.
Well, it's simple, you know, people need a scapegoat. By blaming a specific group of people, we don't blame ourselves for our shortcomings.
But the national defense?
We need to protect the American way.
But wasn't America founded by people who were oppressed for being different in their home country?
Well, yeah, I guess you could say that.
And then shouldn't we not do to them what we didn't want to happen to us?
Look, Billy, you're just too young to understand. We need to profile people in order to keep ourselves safe.
I must be, because I don't understand that keeps us safe. Please explain, Uncle Sam.
Okay. Many people of a certain type have hurt many people of our type.
Our type?
Yes. White Christians.
And their type?
Muslim.
What color?
Excuse me?
Well, you said their type was white. What color is their type?
Brown, I suppose.
Okay, but you said some of them, not all of them.
Well, yes, I'm sure most of them are very nice people.
But we still profile all of them?
You never can tell who is a terrorist.
question, then you know where they aren't, right?
No.
I'm so confused.
Look, not everyone is a brown Muslim.
Really? Which ones, Uncle Sam?
Well, there's Ted Kaczynski, Timothy McVeigh, Dylan Roof, the whole Bundy clan out of Nevada. You know, come to think of it, just about everybody wearing a polo shirt and carrying a tiki torch these days.
But then why do we keep picking on the Muslims?
I wouldn't say we're picking on them.
Is it just because we feel threatened by anyone that's even a little different than us?
Billy. It's such a beautiful day. Let's talk about something else.
Okay. Tell me about Black Lives Matter.
Fuck you.
Okay guys, for your final part of your training, you will be working the front counter taking customers' orders.
Yes! I am prepared to deliver annihilation to the vermin of Earth.
Zadron, what did we say? You can't kill the customers.
Without first mentioning the 2-for-1 onion ring special.
Right!
Hey, Justin, can I have your Snapchat?
Focus, Keenan. And remember, Galaxy Burger 6 word pass to success.
I don't care if it does spell galaxy. It is a fit
acne. Yeah, with the space cowboy said, corporate slogans suck.
I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear that. And just remember my 7-word path to success. Fuck up and I'll kick your ass. Or fuck ya.
Well, thank you too.
Can't give it no time like the present. Step up and take the customer's order.
Hi?
Uh-huh.
Is the register open?
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, I guess I'll have a large solar system meal with the 2-for-1 Saturday.
Hold on a second, posting to Instagram.
I've been waiting for a really long time, and I really just
like... Oh, you're just like my boyfriend.
Seriously?
You always want something. He's always trying to put his thing right at my neck.
That's great. Thank you very much. Ma'am, I am sorry. We here at Galaxy Burger pride ourselves in our customer service and professionalism, and Caitlin there was being a total skank.
Great. So are you going to take my order then?
I would like to, but I'm afraid that's beneath my $10 an hour wage. However, one of our most motivated trainees, Mr. Sagron here, will be happy to take your order.
Greetings, Earther Scum!
Hi. So can I get the large solar system meal with an order of the Saturn rings, a large chocolate Milky Way shake...
But the slut camels of Trinulon! What is the meaning of your girth doing ordering a large anything?
Excuse me?
Like you have enough stored energy to power a Nebula cruiser? You could be an entire front line of battle!
Where did the other, like, less insulty guy go? Because I
think he said it. When I crash landed on this planet, I expected a race of bloodthirsty warriors that I could train for galactic conquest. Not a bunch of spineless, milk-fed pupae suckling on an industrial homogenized heat.
Is this what
you're trying to use?
A
coupon? Oh, I will make rivers run red with your blood, human. I will desecrate the bones of your ancestors. I will analyze your planet and scatter your ashes to the far reaches of
Denied! Denied! We are not cleaning that up again. service.
Okay, well, I think we're just gonna do the two for one onion rings then.
Sure.
Yeah.